Hello and welcome to Microsoft Power BI for Office 365 Preview. In this video, I'll show you how to provision your Power BI for Office 365 Preview tenant. Using your promotional code URL, navigate to the Power BI account setup page. Here you'll be able to fill out all of your information to set up your new account. Note that while at the top there's an option to sign in to add the subscription to your current account, that is not currently supported for the preview. Here where you define your user ID, this will be your administrator ID. When you define the domain, that becomes the name of your preview tenant. Once finished, go ahead and create your account. The tenant will sign you in and proceed to give you options for how to get access to your account should you lose your password. Once logged in, you'll be at the Office 365 Admin Center. Here you'll see a dashboard, which includes links on how to get started with Power BI, and a service overview area that shows you the status of each of your services. Because Power BI depends on SharePoint, we have to wait for the SharePoint service to finish provisioning before we can use Power BI. This can take a few minutes, so in the meantime, we'll set up user licenses. On the Users and Groups page, which you can also see is selected on the left-hand side, you can select your administrator profile. Now you have the option to assign licenses to a particular user, in this case to your administrative user. You'll see the Power BI for Office 365 option, as well as the Office 365 E3 option. Select both options, but make sure to deselect one of the SharePoint Online Plan 2 options. That's because there are duplicate versions of this option, and if both are selected, it will result in a save error. Once you've done that, go ahead and save. Next, you'll see your administrator settings. Here you can update your alternate email address and also set your user location. Now that we've assigned our licenses and set up our user, we can go back to the dashboard to see how provisioning is doing. Here we can see that the SharePoint service is still provisioning. Since Power BI is dependent on it, we'll have to wait a few minutes until it's done. Now I've come back a few minutes later, and I can see that the SharePoint service is finished and there are no issues. To get to my SharePoint site, I click the Sites link at the top right of the page. However, it's still disabled, so I have to refresh the page to enable it. Once I click on the site page, I'm prompted by SharePoint to enable social features. I don't have to, but I'm going to go ahead anyway. At this point, the SharePoint service is provisioned, but it's still being set up and isn't ready to use yet. I'll go ahead and wait for a few minutes until it's done and come back. I return about 10 minutes later and find that the site has been set up. The amount of time it takes can vary based on load. I go to the Sites tab again and click it. On my Sites page, I see a couple of default options for sites. I'll go ahead and click on Team Site. Now I'm on my newly created Team Site. I can see that there's a document library with no documents yet in it, and I'm ready to get started with Power BI. To do that, I'm going to click on the Site Contents link in the left. That leads me to the Site Contents page, where I can see the available apps for this site. The Power BI app is available in this list, so I click it to enable Power BI for this site. Once clicked, I'm navigated to the Power BI homepage where my document library, which as you'll remember was empty, is already showing. If I follow this help link, I'll get a site where I can get sample content, but I'd like to add some content of my own. I click the Add button and choose to upload a file, selecting an Excel file from my local computer. The Excel file is added to the SharePoint document library, and a thumbnail is generated that represents the workbook in Power BI. I can upload many more workbooks and end up with an experience like this, where each workbook is also interactive. When I click on a workbook, it opens it up in the Excel web app, and I can interact with the workbook the same way I could an Excel client. From the Power BI site, I can click Return to SharePoint to return to my original SharePoint page. There I can confirm that all of the workbooks I added were in fact added to the document library. That was our demo for how to provision Power BI for Office 365. Thank you for watching.